Hey there, folks. John at pajamachef.net here, and I thought we could talk about opening beer. See, at Pajama Chef, we're big fans of beer. We mention beer in all of our cooking recipes and our video downloads, so not a bad idea to come check us out and see what's going on with the world of beer and cooking. But right now, we're going to talk about opening beer and what happens in an emergency situation, because if you can't open a beer, that's an emergency. All right. Over here, I'm going to hold up a few different numbers for us. We've got the grandfather's church key. You might recognize that one from a garage nearby you. Very old, but definitely does the trick. We've got the offspring or your dad's church key, and you'll recognize that one for being able to open cans as well as bottles, right? And then finally, you've got the modern day interpretation or the wine key, but there's a little known feature, I think, that a lot of people miss, and that's the old beer opener right there on the end, which is what we use it for primarily around here at Pajama Chef. So, let's use this one to open up a beer. A couple of important things to remember. When you're going to take that top off, you just want to make sure that it's nice and smooth, very mellow. Don't jerk that beer around. That's not good. It should be nice and smooth. And then you're going to take a glass. And you want to make sure that you're pouring the appropriate beer for the appropriate glass. However, if you drink a lot of different beer a lot of the time, and you're like us here at Pajama Chef, you might be happiest with a nice tulip glass. Works well for beer, and this is a sturdy one. So the occasional drop, the occasional blunder, very, very forgiving. All right, folks, now there's an emergency. Nobody's got a beer opener. Well, perhaps you've got a set of tongs. These little guys can totally help you out in a pinch. You'll notice that on the inside of the tongs, there's an opening right there. Well, you need to catch that opening on one side of the beer cap, right here. Then you're going to take your other tong and you're going to set it on top of the cap so it looks just like that. Now all you have to do is pry back, and presto, one open beer. Many a line cook has opened many a beer at a restaurant just like that. Let's get some of this guy going. Awesome, two beers down, one beer to open. No tongs, no openers. Anybody got a light? Because your average Bic lighter with a nice plastic hard outside or any other lighter with a nice hard outside will be easily usable as an opener. Check it out. First, you want to wrap your weak hand. I'm right-handed, so I'm going to wrap my left hand around the top of the bottle. And I'm going to get a couple of fingers up above that cap so it looks just like that. Now, I'm going to take a lighter. I want to take the bottom of that lighter, not the top, but the bottom, and I want to place it between my fingers and that beer cap. Then I wrap my other fingers around and presto. One beer, one cap, one glass. Nice. Now, remember, we're not snobs around here, so you might also recognize this way of opening up a beer. Well, I've got to drink four beers. I need help. So if I could get my wife, Elisa, and our videographer and editor, Alex, to come on over, we can have a nice Pajama Chef cheer. Two fists and cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, that's good. Nice.